Hey everybody, welcome back to another reaction video. Hope you're doing well. My name is Todd. This is the best of Joe Wilkinson on the 8 out of 10 cats. Am I saying that right? I always feel like I'm saying it wrong. That's such an odd name for a show, but... So this is a compilation of all the best moments. I believe it's part 4 of how many? I have no idea, but... This is requested by a Patreon subscriber. You too can join the Patreon. Link down below in the description. We'll get you there. Throw a like in the video. If you like it, subscribe to the channel. If you're new here, hit that notification bell. That way you know when videos post immediately. And you can come check them out. And let's go. Here we go.
Six.
Strong
Two.
Language.
Five.
Fair warning.
75 and 50.
Oh, 50.
And the target, 961.
Oh, give up.
Oh.
Joe, what did you get?
956.
Okay, so how did you do it?
Five times two.
Five times two, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's bloody wrong already. Oh, no, 10. That's 10. 10.
Oh, Jesus.
That does not bode well.
I jumped ahead a bit.
John's not here, and I'm fucking losing again.
And then I did... this is bad even for me. I did times 50, which I then just jumped to that being 1,000, which is not. Then I added a 50 and a 6.
556.
That's absolute dog shit.
By the way, that's literally me trying to do any sort of mental math. Doesn't work out well. Calculators for life.
Fuck off.
Let me mute my watch real quick.
Joe, why have you got a bear with you?
Kind of hoping you wouldn't notice that. Well, we met on the train up here, got chatting, he's escaped from the circus or something, and he's a big fan of the show, so he just sort of followed me here.
Well, that's nice.
No, he likes the proper show, he hates all this fucking shit.
You know what I'm noticing is there's kind of a Will Ferrell kind of vibe to him. It's very funny, like he'll just come out and... character and just kind of go with it.
All right, so what happened? Why are your clothes all ripped to shreds?
Well, we had a few cans on the way up here, and you know how bears get when they're pissed up.
This is the alternate version of The Revenant, by the way.
And I made the mistake of taking a bite out of his chicken and mushroom slice. He went fucking mental.
Joe, how many you got?
Five.
Sean?
Six.
Jimmy? You've got a six. OK, what's your five?
Pints.
Pints.
There's an O there, Joe.
Oh, cock and balls.
Sean?
Depots.
Depots. Is that an E?
That's the E.
Oh.
So, Sean, talk me through how you're feeling at the moment.
Yeah, I'm processing it.
It feels to me like you were so confident you had it all, and then that beat you.
Yeah. Keep your own, love. Got tights.
Well, it's a fairy tale story for you, Joe.
Should we go home?
Well, incredibly, I never thought I'd say it. 5 points to Joe.
Wow.
It's a card from Joe Wilkinson. I'm pretty sure it's from Joe. Dear Jimmy, I have a new job now, so you can stick countdown up your arse. NASA have sent me to a new planet as part of an intergalactic exchange program, and in return, they have sent an alien in my place, so he's going to be on the show instead of me. If you have a problem with that, tough shit. Joe Wilkinson. Right, so I guess please welcome the alien we've swapped for Joe Wilkinson.
All right.
So you're an alien from another planet, are you?
Yep, got a problem with that.
No, no, just you look a lot like Joe Wilkinson.
Yeah, I've heard that. yeah, I've heard we look pretty similar. Main difference is on our planet, we wear berets. Oh, and, yeah, we've got boobs.
Oh, my God. That is hilarious.
You're looking at me, prick.
So, Sean and Kevin have 36. Joe and Victoria have 46.
Yes. Ooh.
That means this is a crucial countdown conundrum. If you get this, you can draw.
Oh.
All right, fingers on buzzers. Your time starts now.
I mean, one is very obvious.
Why did you make me press it then?
Sorry.
Okay, let's restart the clock. False alarm. Sean.
I think I got it.
Sean?
Oh.
Please don't get it.
Well, I was going to say this word, which I think you'll find.
I'm going to restart the clock. Now, you're going to have to press the button pretty much immediately. OK, restarting the clock now. Oh!
Too late.
Joe, I will allow it. What is the word?
No.
What? I haven't heard a gong, Sean. I haven't heard a gong. Joe, what's the word? Quick.
I thought... No, I got it wrong.
Didn't you think it was?
I thought it might be panelist. But there's loads of E's.
No, this is going to have to go to penalties.
This is really difficult. I thought it was plainest, but there's too many E's for that as
they
well.
Still don't have it. I said the word and they still don't have it. That's the level. That's the level we're playing at here. I can say the word and they still go, well, I don't know.
Is it penalties, Jimmy?
Yeah. Is there any way you can edit it so I do that and then you ask me and then I say, is it penalties?
Sure. Joe, what is it?
Penalties.
Oh my God, that's hilarious.
Oh shit, I think he's recognised Rachel off the proper show. He'll probably sniff her, see if he likes her. If he likes her, she's fine. If he doesn't, he'll rip her fucking head off. So this could make quite weird telly. How are you getting on, Len? Oh, he's offering you a can. I think he likes her.
Oh, thank
fine.
You. Just the one.
Hey, I wouldn't take all three.
No.
Can he show you a card trick he learnt at the circus?
Sure.
Pick a card, but don't show Len.
Okay.
Have a look, but don't show Len. Pat,
fuck
off.
Should I show the audience?
Get out of it. No, just put it. Do you remember it? Put it back in. Put it back in anywhere you like.
Okay.
Here we go. You like this, Rachel?
Okay.
You got them? I wake up. Here we go. Go on, then! Go on, then! Here we go. Go on. All right, mate, don't milk it.
Don't milk it.
Is that your card?
That one?
Yeah.
No.
Of course it's not your card! He's a pissed-up bear! Jesus Christ, he had eight Cinzanos on the way here! Look, he hasn't shot himself! Fucking hell. Nice one, Rachel.
Unbelievable.
All right, Timmy.
What are you wearing, mate?
Well, you mean my new trainers? Yeah, nice, aren't they? But, got from George Asda.
No, I mean the rest of it.
Oh, right, yeah. Well, you know I'm banging to me fashion. And so I've bought out my own fashion range. I make all my outfits out of things I find in and around my house. You probably can't tell, but this waistcoat is actually made out of my front and back door. The only downside is my house is being broken into a hell of a lot more.
Is it a good idea to put a grizzly bear in Dictionary Corner?
I'm going to take that away. You going to be all right? Do you want to finish your model? He's in the middle of making a little rocking chair out of old pegs. Do you want to finish that? There you go. That should keep him entertained. It should be all right. Do you want another can? Yeah, all right, have another. There you go. Actually, now you've had enough, you're pissing.
What have we made that out of?
The weakest bear I've ever seen.
I'm a bit annoyed I lost the fight now. Hangover kicking it away. Yeah, he's arsehole. That's him done.
Could be the booze.
That is a wonderful animatronic.
Yeah, he's just
like bear head.
The letterbox there.
You can push your penis through it, yeah.
Okay, on with the game.
Joe, there's someone at the door.
Well played.
Joe laughing is the highlight.
Jimmy Carr's laugh is so iconic.
The window.
Oh, don't. That looks a bit. Don't do that. That looks a bit wrong. It's like a really horny Jehovah's Witness.
David, why have you got your hands in a cup?
No.
What are you doing?
I feel this isn't going to go well for me. My poem's about something very important to me. It's about how come it's okay to name you Willie, but it's not okay to name the fellas Willie next to you at the urinals. So my poem's called Hanging About in a Train Station Toilet, Naming People's Penises.
Well, if you're a fella in the public restroom, you know that there's always that one gap rule where if somebody's on the right, if you're the first one there, you always take the one on the outside. And then if you're the next person in, you take the one on the opposite end. And then if you're a third person, you take the one in the middle. And then if there's no other way to do it without being next to each other, you go in the stall if you're the fourth person. Weird etiquette that we all just happen to know. I don't even know if our fathers taught us that. It's just innate. I don't know why, it just is.
Hello, commuter, on your way to work. I'm going to call yours Captain Birdseye. Because it looks like it's wearing a polar neck and winking at me. Oh. You're welcome. I just named your penis. right.
Hello, train driver who just nipped in for a piss. I'm going to call yours Mrs. Fernsby. My old geography teacher. Because you're small and wrinkly and have a birthmark down the side of your shaft. You're welcome. I just named your penis. Hello, please. Hello,
please. Please stop.
Hello. Hello, police officer. Who's that? Police officer who's just been sent to the toilets because they've had reports of someone naming people.
Oh, God.
You can't arrest me for naming strangers dogs. Oh, you can. I didn't know that. Oh, great. Now I'm electronically tagged again. All right, Jimmy.
Well done.
Oh, God, sorry, I shouldn't really
I've
be
I've never seen Joe Wilkinson before. I never heard of him. That was fantastic.
Why are you here, Joe? You don't work here anymore.
Oh, yeah. God, you're thick as pig shit, aren't you?
Link down below in the description for the original video. Go throw it some love. Obviously a master of props. It reminds me of Whose Line Is It Anyway? It has Drew Carey on there, Ryan Stiles, Colin Mockery. Wayne Brady was on the original casting. Where they would just get a bunch of props and then try to come up on the spot with something to do with them. I mean, that is brilliance. And to just stick to the character and just continue going, like that bear thing kept going and going and going, and it never stopped being funny or weird. What's funny about the guy in the bathroom naming private parts is that that joke went on for so long and he was laughing at it so hard that it began to become like not funny. And then it became funny again. There's that weird, like, up and down of jokes where if you go on for too long, it stops being funny a little bit. And then if you catch them again, it starts being funny again. Like, the police officer thing was just caught it again, and it just made it funny all over again. I've never heard of Joe Wilkinson, as I said previously. Very funny. Reminded me a lot of Will Ferrell. Just that kind of willingness to stick to a character, and it's so off the wall that it just catches you by surprise. And he's so good at it that he just runs with it no matter what happens or what anybody does or what anybody says. He just keeps going with it. Do you have a favorite Joe Wilkinson moment on this show, any other show? It's up to you. Let me know down below in the comments. Thanks so much for watching and laughing with me. I appreciate it. It's always good to laugh. Link down below in the description for the Patreon. Thanks so much for subscribing to the channel. I'll see you in the next one. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.